twice it. Yeah.
Isn't that to increase the parking, the entrance, to increase the parking in order to reduce?
Anyone else?
You can choose.
Okay, now let me tell you. The budget is same for all the countries. And every country is supposed to contribute to the exchequer of the central budget. Greece, especially, what are the plans to repay and what are the means they have arranged to repay? That is never discussed at any point of time by the finance minister. He is always asking about the other countries to fund them. He is always insisting on the Germany to give money, European countries, other countries to finance them. They are asking for a bailout package, but for the last 5 years, there is no contribution, significant contribution by way of this is how we wanted to pay back this money. These are the ways of journey. And Angela Merkel yesterday said in an interview, enough. Now the smart Prime Minister of Greece has to come up with the new proposals, without which we don't want this Greece to remain in the European Union. We want this country to become autonomous and be independent. We run your economy. We can't finance your economy. It is high time now. And you don't pay back, because of which we have to, if you are not paying, this country is not paying. As a group, European has to pay back that money to IMF. Whatever we are agreeing, out of that we need to part this money. We don't want to do this for your faults.
So they said, thing also, they
all have
voted, they still want
bailout
as they voted against
it.
That's a great decision actually, isn't it?
They want to give autonomy to the government. Yeah, please. Yeah, we give you free hand to become independent. All these things, the referendum is split, but in spite of which, the majority of the people, they said yes, let us be autonomous. But we got any plan.
I want to speak about Bajaj, like everyone has just spoken about it. Why is it stop the production of Chetak, and it's going to motorcycles and wants to come back to bringing in scooters of automatic gearing system. And coming to Vespa, Vespa was launched in India in 2012. And the starting price of the Vespa was around 67,000 onward price, and it was the most expensive scooter in India. The question was, will it survive the market in India with the competition with other productions like Honda and Suzuki into the market? The Piaggio executive said that they compared their Vespa scooter to like an iPhone in the scooter market. Like they told the Vespa was an iPhone for the scooter market. And Ravi Chopra, who is the Chief Managing Director of Piaggio Vehicles India, said our strategy was clear. We wanted to create a premium space in the scooter market, which till now did not exist. The Vespa meets the needs of the youth who wish to indulge in luxury but do not have a product to buy. And well, what Chopra said was exactly right. Like India saw over 2.5 million scooters in the last sales in the last financial year, with a growth of about 25%. Now presently the sales of Vespa are around 25,000 per month, and the data given by the executives are the half of the owners of Vespa are mostly women, and their goal was to create a unisex vehicle, scooter vehicle, and they are attracting women as well. And people who prefer buying Vespa are mostly youth or old professionals. And in the late 1960s, where people used to drive a Vespa in India, and same old professionals who want to bring back their youth go for Vespa. And and even people who are interested in fixing and restoring of vehicles, they want to have a collection of new Vespa as well as an old Vespa in their collection. And therefore, Vespar has a the pricing strategy of Vespar has is a success with about 2.5 million sales. And thank you.
A dream for every family member until 2009. And price was around 26,899. It was being launched in 1979 with a joint session with other company. And the name Cheetah has been derived from Maharana Pratap Chariot Horse, which means it's meant for bravery and power. And after the night in the month in the year of 1980, it has been separated from and it has been established individually, and it has been launched the Bajaj Cheetah scooters with a slogan called Hamara Bajaj, and this is how the slogan has been come up, which is showing that 100% Indian made. And during the year 1990, it has already sold 1 lakh units of Bajaj scooters, and also most of the people used to book in advance, giving more money than expected normal price. So this is what the profit and the importance given to change the scooters. And we used to have two types of segments, that is a two-stroke engine and a four-stroke engine. Until 2002, we have a two-stroke engine, and after 2002, we have a four-stroke engine. And the reason is that it's not the matter of the engine fault. The engine is very good. We know the Cheetah engines of Angios and Cheetah helicopters, and in this two-wheeler segment, the Cheetah engines are also being used. And we, with Rahul Bajaj, who is the chairman of this person, and Rajiv Bajaj with the MD during that period, where Rajiv Bajaj was trying to move on with other motorcycle segments, since we have seen after 2000, during the year 2000, that the importance was given to the motorcycles, more than people are preferring motorcycles, so he just suggested and gave, he kept a meeting where he won the conversation, and because of that, there was a drastic decrease in the importance of Cheetah scooters. And as we see that new Cheetah scooter is going to be launched soon, and on Expo in 2006, it went fully automated no gear system. This was PCR. Most of the people will be preferring for smooth flow and for automatic transmission. And just look about the Vespa. Vespa is not the first time it's being introduced in the market. It's already launched in 1950. So this was the third attempt in 2012 that where the Vespa has come to the market, and it has made a concentration so that this since it was the third attempt, he just wanted to know and he just wanted to grab the market as this is the opportunity for them to make people attracted to it. So it just it was concentrating on the young, especially for the youngsters, because as we see the Royal Enfield or etc. any other vehicles are famous for its heritage. So the Vespa company also is trying to do so that they have made so that Vespa should be one among company that we call as heritage. And in Vespa, and final conclusion is that in the Vespa, the main reason for the main purpose of attracting the youngsters is that the speed, the initial speed that is from it goes to 0 to 60 in 9.6 seconds is what, as we see, that's what the present scenario is, because most of the people are very fast, they are on the same time. So these are the things where he can show enough that the speed and the flexibility and the lightweight is what the best part, and this is how it has made a market in India. Thank you.
Shahbaz and Vinay, the next one would be Make in India. I would like to call upon Shinigate and Arvind.
Piaggio Italy has made an attempt, first time with Bajaj. In 1960s, Vespa was the product of Bajaj. Slowly, we changed it to Bajaj Center, Bajaj Car, Bajaj Super, so many were variants their product. Now, after some time, again, they wanted to gain more of Indian market. That's the time they entered with a partner called Lohia Machines. Lohia Machines Limited, LML Vespa. Second time, they made a good deal. They gave a tough fight to Bajaj. And LML has also reasonably did well. and they are receiving of electric vehicles in northern part of India was poor. But the element also lost the grip in the what you call in the wave of motorbikes.